Ben, I must ask you a question.
What's that, Rob?
I'll shave it for later.
Oh my gosh. Hey everyone, I'm Ben. I'm the public information officer with the Santa Fe shelter. And sometimes I serve as a human bird perch. I'm not quite sure what that means, but sometimes birds do land on me. But anyway.
Hey guys.
Now I'm a cat perch. See that cat? This is Jasper.
Hey guys, I'm Rob. I'm the strategic outreach coordinator at the shelter, and I love the outdoors, but not when it's too cold out. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Yes, we really appreciate you taking time out of your day to be with us. We have an amazing show for you today. So we'll have some really interesting, if tragic, pet news, and of course, our training tip with Emily. And our guest is a special one, our community's favorite adoption counselor, Murad Kadar. He'll be on later to talk about all the things, quite crazy questions you guys come up with, or just what happens when he's adopting animals out, and you know what you should look out when you want to adopt a potential furry, feathered, or otherwise scaly friend.
Yeah, and Murad's a special guest, especially because he is a friend of the stars. Murad had a long career.
Is that when
I guess not that long.
Somebody knocks him out, he's friend of the stars?
Yes, he has stars rings around his head because he often gets in bar fights and loses.
Well, let's not talk about that. That's not really fair.
And Murad has also, he's met all of these big names in movies and television, and we have some interesting supporting material to show you. In that regard,
I'm looking forward to that.
Yeah, you'll want to stick around for it. Trust me, it's gonna be very interesting. But first, we have pet news.
Pet news.
Hi, I'm Brock Slater,
and I'm Bolt Upright,
and this is Pet News. Bolt, we actually have some tragic news coming out of Alaska this week.
My home state.
This was Ben's home state, not Bolt's.
That's right.
Anyway, so persona. The Iditarod was in Alaska, I think, at the airing of this particular program 2 weeks ago. And some of you may have heard about a tragic thing that happened there. A musher and her dog team, two different mushers and their dog teams, were targeted by a man on a snowmobile, run over. One dog died tragically relatively soon after, and a number of dogs were critically injured. It's
kind of a crazy thing.
It's bizarre, of course. And Bolt here channeling Ben back in our other studio.
I interviewed Ben exclusively for this story because he is from Alaska and he does know a lot about the Iditarod Trail.
And what did he have to say?
So, you know, every year there's a tragedy that happens on the Iditarod Trail. A lot of times, you know, it's a tough track. But the thing about the Iditarod that people in Alaska really like to, you know, for us, it's a celebration. It commemorates the a historic run from Anchorage to Nome in 1925. There was an outbreak of diphtheria. They didn't have enough serum for the children, and the whole town was, you know, was in danger of really people dying. And so these people got together, and they did the first Iditarod, which was taking all the serum to Nome and successfully helping treating those children.
Which is a really interesting story, and obviously it's become a big part of kind of, you know, the Alaska lifestyle.
Yeah, and you know, we have a big celebration around it too, the Anchorage Fur Rendezvous Festival. And then there's something we talked a little bit about, is that the fact, because the last couple of winters have been actually warm, they've had to move. Well, they used to have to truck in snow to Anchorage to start it. Basically, it was kind of a big show, you know, they'd truck in all the snow, and then they'd go through and then they'd actually start it in Willow. And now they have to go farther and farther north just because of global warming.
Yeah.
But there's something you might not know about the Iditarod Trail.
There's, I'm sure, much I don't know about the Iditarod
Trail. The first initial dogs, so I think the dog was, Balto and Tongo. And Balto, the statue of him, is in New York's Central Park. But his body is elsewhere.
Where is it? Where? In Alaska, I assume.
No, Cleveland. But Togo, that was the other dog that I messed up his name on, his body is actually in the Wasilla Museum, Iditarod Trail Museum. It's kind of crazy. I've seen it as a kid.
So. Yeah, it's something, you know, just loving dogs, that I find as an interesting cultural phenomenon. But yeah, in this case, I mean, obviously the threat to the Iditarod from climate change is tragic. This is bizarre and obviously tragic, because why would somebody do this? Why would somebody run down dogs on a,
well,
a snowmobile?
You know, he obviously has an alcoholic problem, and so
that was
according
his
to the news story. Actually, you know, there is a terrible problem with alcoholism in interior Alaska and rural areas of Alaska. Mm-hmm. And he says he blacked out and he didn't know what happened until he woke up and he didn't even remember it.
I'm afraid, I guess, I don't know, that I don't, you have to have some seeds of, malice in you to even want to do that when you're heavily, heavily intoxicated, run someone down.
Like that. I think it's crazy, but, you know, there's, like I said before, every year there's a tragedy. A lot of people really don't like the sport, mm-hmm. but as a perspective from Alaskan, these are working dogs, and they do, you know, it's not just for play, and I lived in the Arctic for quite a while, and these dogs were working dogs, and they, you know, took people to the fishing holes and things like that. Mm-hmm. Anyway.
So yeah, we don't know again why this man chose to do this. You know, if it was something that was anger or malicious, just remember, folks, we've covered this topic before. The FBI is now keeping track of animal abuse cases because they do recognize that they are indicators for violence committed against humans later on. And it's something that we should all be aware of. Somebody who is okay hurting an animal is not okay. And they're three times more likely to abuse some sort of human, whether it be the child, spouse, boyfriend, girlfriend, whatever, coworker. So stay on top of that. If you notice somebody who seems violent in whatever way, you know, see something, say something, just be aware that pathological violence isn't just restricted to animals.
And that's it for pet news.
Thank you, Brock and Bolt.
Thank you. That was very informative.
Very informative, tragic, but we appreciate it.
And now we have something even more informative.
Pet Train Tip of the Week with Emily.
Dun, da, da.
Hi, Trainer Emily here, and welcome to Training Tip Tuesday. This is Duchess, and she'll be helping me further talk about what we've been focusing on this month, which is tips for puppy problems. So every owner has to deal with chewing. It's a normal, natural behavior for puppies. Most of the time they do it in relation to attention and play. So the first thing you can definitely do is encourage them to put their mouth and play with things that it's safe for them to play with, their toys, preferably soft toys. Do you want that? You want that? Oh, get that. You get that. There you go, get that. Okay? That way they're chewing on their toys and not you. Oh, ouch. If the puppy chews on you, you say ouch and stand up. This is similar to what dogs would do with one another. They might yelp and run away. But the brief time out takes away the attention that is fueling the mouthing behavior. If you stand up and give a time out from standing up and the dog still continues to jump on you, you can find somewhere safe to put the dog, such as a pen as we have here, or a laundry room or kitchen, so long as it's safe and the dog isn't going to get into anything. Timeouts don't need to be long, just 30 seconds. And then after 30 seconds, you can try and engage them and play again. Come here. Look at this. Oh, get that. You get that. Grr, grr. Grr, get that. Oh, get it. There it is. Thanks for having me on your show, Robin Ben. See you next week.
Hey, thank you, Emily. That was really informative, and I appreciate your help. You know, you can watch those tips every Tuesday on Facebook, and then obviously Thursdays here on the High Desert Podcast. And now, dun da da da, we want to introduce
our main segment, Murad Adib
Kajar. The meat and potatoes.
Has been with the Santa Fe Animal Shelter for 2 years, and is one of our community's favorite adoption counselors, although they're all our favorites, of course. And in his past life was a showbiz star. Here's a brief clip of him in action.
Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Dave Adib Letterman. The guy here from Turkey. There he is. This man is from Turkey. Your name is Murad Adib Kadar. Yeah, cute. Wanted to get this in early because we know you'll be falling asleep soon. Huh?
Wait to get my cousin's name. My sister's
Okay, no, seriously. You know, we only have an hour. And I have a few things I'd like to cover, but...
Hi. Welcome, welcome.
Hi.
Yeah, you did something that was really cool earlier today. Can you tell us again? Can you count to 10 in Turkish?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So, bir, iki, üç, dört, beş, altı, yedi, sekiz, dokuz, on.
What's five again?
Biriki Dirbesh. Besh.
So you, Dirbesh. Your parents are from Turkey, but you guys immigrated to the States.
Yeah, my parents came to America
20 years ago. Right?
My parents. Yeah, exactly. My parents came here some 40 years ago, something, to find the American dream,
and they found it in Phoenix.
The dream was me. I was the dream.
That's really awesome.
More like a consolation prize. we're just kidding.
So, but you also have some really. Can you give us a little bit of your background, because it's really pretty fascinating.
So I used to work for NBC Telemundo for 20 years. And during that time, I was doing all the media marketing for them. So with that, we had to do a lot of socializing and partying with some
it's always such a
top
pain.
Celebrities. And but it was work. Hanging out with
hard work.
The Brad, you know, back in the '60s, yeah, that was the Brat Pack, right?
'60s.
Oh, I'm sorry. It was the Brat Pack,
exactly.
No, the Brad Pitt. I thought you said Brad. Oh, okay, I got it.
But yeah, it was. We partied with a lot of them, from the Brad Pitts to the Pamela Andersons. But it was all work. It was work.
To some ugly people too.
To some ugly people.
Okay. So, how'd you end up then here in Santa Fe doing animal welfare work?
So, after 20 years doing corporate America, I just decided I wanted to change in lifestyle. And so we moved to Santa Fe.
Because we don't have any corporations here.
That's right. And I actually came into the shelter to volunteer, and I got hired. So, I've been here doing the adoption counseling thing for almost 2 years now.
It's funny. I mean, that's a great story, and it's not totally unique to Santa Fe though. There's a lot of people who seem to just say, "I'm dropping everything."
They're hiding. They're all hiding. That's what I say.
So it's, you know, it's a huge witness protection community.
Let's not go into that. Remember, we promised not to bring up the
mention it.
Right.
So you know, I think what really your talent is, especially here at the shelter, is a relationship that you build with people who come in who are looking for an animal. You know what? So it's really important that they understand what type of animal that they want. Right. Some people want, they think they want a dog, but they really want a cat.
Right.
And how do you, because of your skills, you're schmoozing, that's really helped to make it, make better matches.
Well, I always ask people five simple questions. When you're ready to adopt an animal, are you willing to commit time? It does take a lot of time once you bring in a dog or a cat. What is your living situation like? Are you renting? Are you owning? Do you have roommates? Are people allergic? Do you have a fence in the backyard? Can you afford the animal? Getting the adoption is one simple step, but after that, you got to think of the food, the grooming, the toys, and God forbid, the vet bills. So yeah. Those all add up. Also, how much time do you have? Are you going to be able to groom the animal? Are you going to be able to exercise the animal? Patience. And patience is like
a virtue.
Number five, yeah, because patience comes with toilet training, and you have to be able to deal with that. And a lot of people freak out the first time the pet goes to the bathroom in the house.
I think they forget that animals are animals, and that and they really follow our behavior.
Yeah.
So you know, it's really interesting that you talked about the vet bill, because you've had some really. I mean, how many animals you have?
I have four dogs,
right?
Yeah.
And some of them are sick, and so I saw you the other day at the Thaw Animal Hospital, our public animal hospital, and
a great. Hospital by
with Ashley. Okay. So I'm sure we're going to show a photo of you with Ashley. And how's she doing?
She's actually doing better. Awesome. So yeah. So Dr. Getz, great doctors here, and they really helped her.
Thank you.
Yeah, I don't think anybody could get to put together a better list of things to think about. I mean, it's I don't know that some people definitely do get pets on an impulse type of thing, but you're right. I mean, patience, and the thing that Ben and I have mentioned before about when you adopt a pet is that, you know, it does take a lot of time, but you develop an emotional connection to that pet. So it doesn't always seem like work,
right.
Of course.
You right.
know, it's something that you end up enjoy doing. Maybe not cleaning up the poop so much, but, you know, it's kind of amazing that we can also teach these animals to be house trained, I think.
Yeah.
And to catch your, you know, get your socks.
Yeah.
To get your socks. Get your socks dress in the morning. I saw that episode. Great episode. I love watching the show.
Thank you, Murad.
Murad's our biggest fan of the show. I'm sure you have some good stories about working at the adoption desk. Do you have one you want to share with us?
Well, I do have one. When I about 6 months into my job here, I was doing an adoption with this lady. And halfway through the adoption, she just started crying and just bawling everywhere. And I grabbed her hand. And I go, "You okay?" And she grabbed my hand. And she goes, "Well, I just want you to know that you've helped me find my little buddy in life.
That's really cool.
And that's when I realized, you know what? I'm not doing this just for the animals. I'm doing it for people too. And helping that find that connection for the homeless animals and also for the people that want a pet and a best friend. That's why I'm here.
It's important.
Yeah. Makes you feel good.
Yeah. I think it's, you know, for some people, especially like us, they're some of our best friends. So to be able to be there when that connection happens, that's going to be hopefully a connection they have for 10 or 15 years. It's a really beautiful thing to see. Okay. Got a little bit sentimental there, but now we have a very exciting segment. We're not doing so much a game today as we are.
I look forward to it.
Oh, don't pretend that you're disappointed, Ben.
Goodness.
With my surprise games.
No games. Oh, no.
Okay, so, Murad, actually, I think you're going to show us these pictures.
Oh, okay.
And we're going to try to guess who they are and also comment a little bit about.
I don't recognize what you were holding because I thought, what?
Those are the first one I took a peek at. It's easy because this guy looks exactly the same. How old is this picture?
That was taken last year.
Great. And that is President Barack Obama. It is Brad Pitt. What is this event? It looks like an eighth grade dance.
You know, honestly, I can't remember what event it was, but I do remember I walked up to Brad and I go, can I get a photo with you? It's just like, I get photos. And he's like, you know what? Not right now. I'm busy. And he walked away. About a half hour later, he comes up to me, taps me on the shoulder and he goes, let's get that photo.
Not bad for a guy from Ohio.
Just minutes later.
He's not as tall as I thought he was.
Just minutes later. Can you guess who this one is?
That's a woman.
Hillary Clinton.
His ex-wife, Jennifer Aniston.
Yeah, that's Jennifer Aniston.
Were they together at the time?
They were not together.
Oh, Murad the matchmaker.
But if I got the photo together, then that would be like worth something.
Maybe you would have sold it to Hello Magazine.
That's right.
Probably worth less now.
Can you guess who this one is?
I don't know. There's a creeper on the left there watching this.
Oh, wow, the hair. Is that Cameron Diaz?
Cameron Diaz?
I don't know.
Anderson.
I always wanted to see Cameron
Diaz. Pamela Anderson.
I don't recognize her because she's not wearing a swimsuit. Sorry.
Formerly Pamela Anderson Lee.
Oh, that's...
This one's my favorite.
We have to show it to the camera.
This is Jimmy Jovine with...
I like butter?
Fabio. Was this before or after Goose in the Face incident? Do you remember that?
I don't know what that is.
What? Fabio was riding a roller coaster and his face crashed into a goose.
Really?
Killed the goose with a face like that, rock hard.
What am I see this?
Chiseled.
Oh, that's a little blurry, but he doesn't. Do you know who
that looks? That's Carson Daly with the lead singer of REO Speedwagon.
Oh, that's me. Me along with, don't look at the girl, look at the guy.
That's Elton John.
There you go.
Photobombing a photo with Elton John and his friend.
Here's one. Here's a classic one.
Can you get that one, Ben? I know who it is. I cheated.
He looks familiar.
This is a classic one.
A classic?
I will say he sits in movie theaters and watches himself. He sits in an elevator
now. His eyes are closed. I can't really see.
Shia LaBeouf.
Okay.
Was that at his...
This was his very first movie when he did the HBO show Project Greenlight.
Oh, cool.
So you know, this was just when he became...
This was good rehearsal for you for now that your photobombing career at the shelter.
That's right. I do a lot of photobombing.
If you watch our Facebook page, you follow us on Facebook, which I recommend, so you know everything that was going on at the shelter. But Murad is a famous photobomber with all the dogs.
It's not so much photobombing as it is you guys taking pictures, like you taking pictures of...
No, he insists.
No, I photobomb.
Yeah, he photobombs.
But Murad... speaking about photobombing, I know you guys want to get me out of here, but I understand that you guys are having a contest with with mustaches. No. So I would like to submit my dog, Lexi, with her mustache.
I don't think that's this real.
It's very real.
It doesn't look real to me.
I think there's some product in it, but I think maybe it could be
legitimate. I love when people throw out the word product just like that. I just like it.
What? Yeah, because it's so product. General, it doesn't actually mean anything?
No. It's just, it feels like it brings us up a little bit. And I love the product that you put in. Well,
a two-syllable word. It's elevating the program.
Yeah, but product means so much. It used to mean something else, and now it means this. And it's just, thank you for doing it.
I'm in a cosmetic product.
I know you did. That's
okay.
Why I said it.
Okay. So.
Anyway, yeah, can he stick around for our photo contest?
Yeah, stick around for our mustache photo contest.
Because he's obviously trying to win his favor with us, and it's not going to happen. Not going to happen.
Lexi.
It's featured. It's a runner-up,
Thank you. Thank you.
So now we have our pet photo contest. Ben, do you want to tell them what that was all about?
So last week we asked our followers to send pictures of their pets with mustaches, and boy, did they deliver.
As did I, Ben.
Thank you, Rob, for that delivery.
You're welcome.
And here are our top three picks.
Okay, we have Rob three picks. So we got, this was an overwhelming response to our thing. Most of them seem to be Tuxedo Cats. These are our top three picks. The first one is Wilhelmina, sent in by Rose via Facebook. No, this is to our podcast website, podcast@sfhumanesociety.org, PAWEDCAST. We had a lot of Tuxedo Cats. This one looks weirdly like my cat, and I'm thinking maybe somebody broke into my house. This one was sent to us from Landeros. Didn't give us a location or the name of the
couple,
cat.
A couple of the cats. Yeah, cat.
I think really, she has
a very sweet cat.
Has a few cats.
Yeah,
maybe so. And the top winner? Just like my cat.
The top winner.
Top winner is, without a doubt, has the best mustache. This is Laura and Dave's cat from Proctor, Vermont. Didn't give us a name. Charlie. Actually, they did give us a name. His name was Charlie.
I like it.
So thank you, Laura and Dave from Vermont.
Charlie Chaplin.
That is one impressive handlebar mustache. Lip
strong.
For a cat.
Vermont. Well, Murat, you were awesome. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you so much for joining us.
I hope you come back again with more celebrity photos. And
she got a runner-up. She got a mention.
You know, we forgot to say that Murat also is he's an actor who continues his career here in New Mexico, and you'll see him in many different kinds of films.
What's the most recent film you were in?
Currently in Whiskey Tango Foxtrot with Tina Fey.
WTF.
Oh, I didn't know that.
That's right. And filmed here in New Mexico.
In Land of Enchantment.
That's right.
So thank you guys so much for joining us this week. And thank you, Murat, for coming on as a guest. You know, it's really important to have you all here. We're going to do a selfie in a second because that's our thing now. So you'll catch that.
Selfie in a second.
Selfie in a second. And obviously, we can't do this without you. So remember to donate if you can. And short of that, share the podcast, review it on iTunes. It makes kind of our results go further up in the ranking. And so more people who aren't aware of this can become aware of it. And we can continue to spread the word about all these important issues.
Spread the word, share the love.
There we go.
Like it.
Like it. With Facebook,
thanks,
you
Jasper.
Can do all sorts of, do the little heart one on Facebook.
I like the heart one.
You can find us on our website. What was like this? Our website, iTunes, Android, iPhone, on SoundCloud, anywhere you get podcasts, on YouTube, on
and
Facebook.
Special thanks for Jamie for throwing Jasper onto the table again. And all the,
and
all,
just being an all-around great videographer and being patient with our nonstop
antics. Sorry, Kitty.
Perfect. Thank you all, and we will see you, next week. Bye. Ouch, did you hear that?
Mm-hmm.
That hurt.